Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I have brought to you this video where you will be having a lot of information related to a new indigenous breed of buffaloes that have been recognized by the government of India. Also, we will be discussing about a project called Dunbar that has been launched recently. There is the first city in the South Asian region that has implemented its own climate action plan. So all of this is there in this video. So let's quickly begin the video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed our channel, then do it now, and you can hit the bell notification as well. This is the Telegram group which you can join in order to get the PDF of this session, and the link of this group is in description below. So here is the first question about the Manda buffalo breed. So where is the Manda buffalo breed found? Maharashtra, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Madhya Pradesh are in the options, out of which Odisha is the right answer. Guys, this buffalo breed has been recognized as the 19th indigenous buffalo breed in India. That's why it is important. Particularly the NABARD students, you have to listen to me very carefully, because this forms a part of your animal husbandry current affairs. Okay, so that is also that comprise a little bit portion of your NABARD ARD examination. So do listen to me very carefully. So this breed is found in Odisha, and the Eastern Ghat area, which lies in the state of Odisha, has a proliferating population of this breed of buffaloes. So let's have a look at the features of this buffalo and about the current news in detail. So the National Bureau of Animal Genetic Resources, where this institution or organization is located in India, that you have to tell me in the comment section below. So this organization has recognized Manda buffalo, which is found in Odisha's Korakpur district and adjoining areas of Malkangiri and Nabarangpur. So in all these three areas, this Manda buffalo breed is found. So this breed has been recognized as the 19th buffalo breed in India. Okay, so here is the description of this buffalo, that Mandas are small, sturdy buffaloes, and both male and females are used for plowing and in agricultural operations in these areas. Manda buffaloes are characterized by their flat forehead with short muzzle, broad semicircular horns. These buffalo has ash gray and gray colored coats with copper color hair. Some animals are silver white in colors as well. There are 1 lakh Manda buffaloes in the Eastern Ghat region. So these were the features of the Manda buffaloes. Okay. Moving on to the next question, which is the first South Asian city to launch a climate action plan. Mali, Shri Jayavardhanpura Kote, Mumbai, Kathmandu, Thimphu are in the options, out of which the right answer is Mumbai. So Mumbai has become the first city in the South Asian region to have its own climate action plan. Now guys, you also need to know that in 2020, in the later part of 2020, Mumbai joined the grouping of C40. So C40 is basically an initiative that includes cities. So it has a total number of 97 cities I'm talking about, cities as its members. And what is the function of the C40 grouping, or the purpose? Basically, this provides knowledge, this provides a platform for all the member cities to share expertise and knowledge so that they can tackle the climate change. Okay, so that is the purpose. And by gaining knowledge from the C40 member cities, Mumbai has created its own Mumbai Climate Action Plan. Okay, so that was all about this question, about this news. But you also need to know that Mumbai is not the only city from India that is a member of C40. There are other cities as well. So what are the names of those cities? Delhi, Mumbai, as we have already read it, Bangalore, Chennai, Kolkata, and Jaipur. So these are the cities that are members of the C40 initiative. Do remember this thing, okay? Which state has launched e-receipt 2.0 portal to enhance electronic payment of taxes and dues easier? Okay, so basically this portal has been launched in order to provide a platform for the citizens so that they can pay their taxes easily on the electronic platform. So which state has done so? Odisha, Delhi. Delhi is not a state. Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Kerala are in the options. Odisha is the right answer. And for providing or launching this platform, or we can say facilitating the smooth payment on this platform, this Odisha state has partnered with Indian Bank and Axis Bank. Okay. So these two banks have partnered with Odisha government for this e-receipt 2.0 portal. Which of the following objectives is the project Dhanbar related to? Testing of central bank digital currency, gathering of digital land use data, assessment of satellite based agroforestry data, installation of auto agro weather forecast station, distribution of credit among small and medium enterprises. So these are the five options, out of which option A is the right answer. Now the very first thing that I want to make clear here is that this project has nothing to do with India. It has been launched by the four central banks of different countries. Okay, so let's have a look at this project in detail. First of all, Central Bank of Australia, Malaysia, Singapore and South Africa. So these are the four countries that have launched this project Dhanbar. And the basic purpose of this project is to check the feasibility of using the digital currency in settling the international payments. Therefore, all of these banks are connected. All of these central banks have come together to work on this project Dhanbar. Now, the organization that is helping all these central banks is Bank for International Settlement. Okay, you can see it here. Bank of International Settlement Innovation Hub. So this is the organization that is providing the technical support as well as the other expert support that all these central banks need in order to check the feasibility of using the digital currencies in international payment settlements. Okay. Now the result of this project will be published in 2022. Now, not an important point from exam point of view. Now, the names of the central banks of all these countries. So, Reserve Bank of Australia, Bank Negro Malaysia, Monetary Authority of Singapore and South African Reserve Bank. These are the names of the central banks of these countries. And Singapore Center will be leading this project. Okay, I hope that this project is clear to you. Guys, do remember the names of the countries that are involved in this project. Next question is coming from the project Dhanbar itself, but it is not directly related to that. Where is the headquarter of Bank of International Settlement located? So Bank of International Settlement Innovation Hub was a partner in project Dhanbar, and from there this question is here. So this is indicating that you have to open your mind, you have to open your horizons in order to cover the current affairs. Okay, if one news has been given to you, that does not mean that you will stick yourself to that only. If the Minister of External Affairs has visited a country in South Africa, let's say Senegal, then you need to cover the currency, capital, location of that country on your own. Okay, so this is how you can open your horizons in preparing the current affairs. Okay, so where is the headquarter of this organization located? It is located in Basel, Switzerland. So here are some details related to this Bank of International Settlement. So let's have a look at it. The establishment year is 1930. Total 63 central banks are members of this organization, which represent about 95% of the world GDP. Headquarters is in Basel, Switzerland, and it has two representative offices, one in Hong Kong and the other one is Mexico City. And innovation hubs are all over the world. The purpose of this organization is to promote and support the central bank's pursuit of monetary and financial stability through international cooperation and to act as a bank for the central banks. Okay, so Bank of International Settlement, as the name itself is indicating the purpose of this bank. Okay, so it undertakes, first of all, it promotes the banks, it helps the central banks so that they can achieve monetary and financial stability, and secondly, it undertakes all the work of settlement, payment settlement at the international level. Okay, so that is all about this Bank of International Settlement. Bell Pola Festival is celebrated in which of the following states? Mizoram, Tripura, Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir, Maharashtra are in the options, out of which Maharashtra is the right answer. So Bell Pola, it is basically a Thanksgiving festival in the farming community. So farmers celebrate this festival in order to show their gratitude towards the oxes and the bulls for their contribution in agriculture. But this festival is not only celebrated in Maharashtra, it is also celebrated in other parts of India. So let's have a look at the other parts of India and some things about this Bell Pola festival. So it is celebrated in Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Telangana and Karnataka. Okay. The day is also celebrated as Pola Amavasya in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. So Bell Pola in Maharashtra, the name of this festival is Bell Pola in Maharashtra and Pola Amavasya in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. And on this day, they express their gratitude towards bulls and oxes. This day falls on Pitori Amavasya. Okay, not at all a very important point for you, but this is important that recently this festival was celebrated in Maharashtra. Okay, that is why this festival is in the news. So which state celebrated this Bell Pola festival recently? Then the answer would be Maharashtra. Okay, and in south, Matu Pongal is the festival that is celebrated to thanks or to show the gratitude towards oxes and bulls. Okay, so this is the name of this festival. You can say both of these festivals are similar in nature. So this is the name in south. Which of the following exercise has been recently started by India and Australia at the Darwin City of Australia? So basically this exercise has started in September only, from September 5th. Okay. So what is the name of that exercise? Austro-Hind, Ausindex, Malabar, Pitch Black, both B and C. The right answer is Ausindex. So this Austro-Hind is the army exercise. This is the navy exercise. This is again navy exercise, but between the Quad members. So it also includes Japan and US. This is the Air Force exercise between India and Australia only. Okay. So this Ausindex exercise started in the year 2015 and it is a biennial exercise occurring once in 2 years. Okay. So this is the fourth edition of this exercise that has started at the Darwin City. And this is for the first time in the history of this exercise, which is just as 4 year old. So in that this exercise is taking place at the Northern Territory of Australia at this Darwin City. Okay, so do remember this thing. So this is the harbor phase and the sea phase will take place in the North Australia exercise area, which is around the sea. Now the other news related to India and Australia, which is important, is the 2+2 dialogue. So after this exercise, 2+2 dialogue will be conducted between India and Australia. Now this is the first time that this dialogue will be conducted at the ministerial level. From earlier this time, this was held at the secretary level, but last year the prime ministers of both the countries upgraded its level to the ministerial level. Okay, now you should know that 2+2 dialogue, basically here foreign plus defense collaboration between different countries are discussed by India. Okay, so this 2+2 dialogue is conducted by India with all the Quad member countries, Australia, US and Japan. Recently, India also proposed to establish the 2+2 dialogue with Russia, but no news is there regarding the establishment of this 2+2 dialogue so far. So do remember that this would be the first time that this 2+2 dialogue would be held at the ministerial level. Before this, it was held at the secretary level. What is the theme of International Day of Clean Sky, Clean Air for Blue Sky? So it is celebrated on September 7, and in 2020 it was the first edition in 2020, and this is the second edition of this day. What is the theme in 2021? The theme is Healthy Air, Healthy Planet. So guys, that was all for today's video. I hope that you have enjoyed and learned a lot during the video. Thank you.